Hello everyone, in this segment we are discussing about reverse biased p-n junction diode. Now in earlier video we have already seen a forward biased p-n junction diode where we have seen its working principle as well as its VI characteristics. Now let us start with what do we mean by reverse biased p-n junction diode. Now the first point we can write when p-type semiconductor is connected to negative terminal and n-type is connected to positive terminal, such kind of junction diodes are called as reverse bias p-n junction diode. So this is the simplest definition about the reverse bias p-n junction diode. Now when I come across its schematic, so we can draw two semiconductors. They are being connected. The first one, again we'll treat this as p-type, and the other one we'll check it as n-type semiconductor. So here I am just connecting this with n-type semiconductor. Now we know again, in case of n-type semiconductor, we have electrons as majority charge carriers. So we'll write all these as electrons. They are negatively charged. These are the majority charge carriers, which we call it as electrons. And here we have majority charge carrier as holes. So we can take holes as majority charge carriers. So they are being all positive. So here, these are the holes. Now holes are majority charge carrier in p-type semiconductor, and we also know that in case of n-type semiconductor we have holes as majority charge carriers, and in case of p-type semiconductor we have electrons as minority charge carriers. अब देखिए majority minority हमें जो है वो ध्यान में लेना पड़ेगा. In case of p-type electrons are minority charge carriers. Now we'll connect them with the terminals. Here negative terminal is connected to p-type and positive terminal, this is negative, this is positive. So negative terminal is connected to p-type, positive is connected to n-type. So such combination is called as a reverse bias p-n junction diode. Now how actually it works, this is important. Okay, now what happens here, we have a negative polarity, so this is negative polarity. And here majority charge carriers are holes. So negative and positive, there will be a force of attraction. Now due to this force of attraction, these holes will try to come towards the negative terminal. So there will be a movement of holes towards negative terminal. Similarly, as here we have positive terminal and all the majority charge carriers are electrons which are negatively charged. So similarly, these electrons will be attracted towards positive terminal. See, holes are attracted towards negative and electrons are attracted to the positive terminal. Now due to which, what happens, the width of this depletion layer goes on increasing. Okay, why? Because more number of holes are trying to come here, more number of electrons are trying to come here. Now as the width of this particular region goes on increasing, there will not be possibility of combination of holes and electrons, and due to which the current that flows in this particular reverse bias is very less, or we can call it as a very low amount of current flows in reverse bias junction diodes. Typically we can say that in case of reverse bias p-n junction diode, no current flows through the circuit. Now when I consider across its typical values, so we can have reverse current which I am denoting as IR, is always in microamp. Remember, in case of forward bias it was milliampere, now in case of reverse bias it is in microampere. Now when we go on increasing this particular voltage, more number of holes, more number of electrons will come down here, and at one stage what happens, there will not be any holes here and electrons over here, and due to which this particular junction totally get break down. What happens, it completely get break down, and that phenomena or that region we can call it as breakdown region. And due to this breakdown region, there will be a sudden increase in current. Okay, so in case of forward bias, it was a gradual increase in current, but after 0.7 volt it was suddenly increased. But here, once it crosses the breakdown region, there will be a sharp increase in the current, and that region is called as the breakdown region. Okay, and this breakdown region is not suitable for any of the tires because it can harm the circuitry. So ideally what we have written, no current flows in reverse bias junction tire. Now in when I draw its characteristics curve also, so here we'll be placing all the terminologies in the same way. So we can have a negative potential which is applied here, and we have a current as IR which is in microampere. Okay, now once you start to increase the potential from 0, let's suppose 0.1, 0.2 and so on, what happens, once it crosses a region, there will be a sudden increase in current, and that remains same. That means the current is not under control. Okay, and this region is called as a breakdown region. Okay, and we can note it down as VBR, that stands for potential across the breakdown region. Remember, this is a breakdown region, and this potential is called as a breakdown potential, and this current is reverse current, which is measured in terms of what, microampere. So this is about the VI characteristics of reverse bias PN junction diagram. Now coming to the last point from this discussion, and that will be current equation. So the current equation, I can represent reverse current IR will be equal to I naught into e raised to minus V divided by neta VT minus 1. Okay, so in case of forward bias it was plus, now here it is negative. Rest of the terms are same. This is the applied potential V, neta is equals to 1 for germanium and 2 for silicon, and thermal voltage VT has same value. VT stands for thermal voltage, which has potential 26 millivolt at 300 degree Kelvin. Okay, neta 1 for germanium and 2 for silicon. So this is all about reverse bias PN junction diode. I hope you understood the concept behind the reverse bias PN junction diode also. Thank you very much.